What we have here is a halogen lamp, properly known as tungsten halogen or quartz halogen lamp. And this lamp is actually an incandescent source, which a lot of people may or may not be aware of. It works on the same principle as an ordinary incandescent bulb. Current passing through a high resistance filament heats it to a high degree of incandescence, and it produces bright white light. The difference with halogen is, number one, the outer envelope is made out of quartz instead of glass, and it's much smaller for the same wattage. And that's one reason for quartz to withstand the higher heat, because of the smaller bulb. Secondly, the bulb is filled with a halogen gas, which is unique in that it causes what's known as the halogen regenerative cycle. When the filament operates, tungsten atoms will evaporate off of the filament and deposit on the inside of the bulb, and it'll cause the bulb to blacken over time, which is familiar with ordinary incandescents. Halogens don't usually blacken much, if at all, because when the atoms come off of the filament, they unite chemically with the halogen, and when the halogen cools, the chemical compound changes yet again and actually redeposits the tungsten atoms right back on the filament again. And that prevents the filament from thinning down quickly and evaporating, so you can run it at a higher temperature and produce more light and greater efficiency with no loss of lamp life. As a matter of fact, you can increase the efficiency over an incandescent quite a bit and actually get longer lamp life from a halogen, which is a great advantage to it. The only main disadvantage of this lamp is that they run so extremely hot, and they're better off to be put in an outer envelope like these types are for household use. And also, you can't touch the bulbs with your fingers, because quartz, if your skin oil gets on the quartz and it gets hot, it goes through what's known as devitrification, which is what happened to this lamp. You see the quartz is all discolored and messed up. The filament is actually still intact, but the reason why this bulb looks like it does is because somebody touched it with their bare hands and then put it in use. And the heat of the lamp actually damaged the quartz. If this lamp were to be put in service, it wouldn't last very long, and it might even explode. So when you install a quartz lamp that has no outer bulb, no outer envelope, always hold it with a piece of tissue, or like I'm doing, hold it by the base so you don't touch the quartz. If you do touch the quartz, use rubbing alcohol and tissue paper to clean it off before you put it in service, and you won't have a problem. These are known as double-ended halogen lamps because the current is fed in from both ends of the lamp, almost like a fluorescent tube. And of course, there's single-ended format lamps as well, which, again, the automotive lamp, the headlight bulb, is a single-ended halogen type bulb. And this one's for an overhead projector, single-ended type. And there's smaller versions of these that you find in under cabinet lighting in kitchens, 12-volt ones and line voltage ones for a variety of applications. Other single-ended lamps are the ones that have an outer envelope, like this small floodlight bulb that screws directly into a socket. And these are for track lighting and accent lighting in the home and in business. You've got your single-ended bulbs for general lighting. And these are coming out in different types now. This is an older version, but they're still popular today. And a BT15 outer envelope fits a standard socket. And these are actually a great alternative to compact fluorescent bulbs. They're still considered energy efficient, yet they don't have the quirks that CFL bulbs do, and they have the same color quality as a standard incandescent. Plus, they're dimmable, which most CFLs aren't. For chandelier lighting, now they have halogen bulbs, which are a little more energy efficient. Okay, what we have here is a 500 watt T3 halogen bulb. It's probably the most familiar type of halogen bulb aside of the automotive type ones. And this particular format is actually the original format of halogen bulb, which came out back around 1962. Here's a pretty nifty halogen lamp. It's made by Iwasaki Electric Company in Japan. And what this is, it's what they call a double envelope halogen lamp. This bulb was probably used for general lighting, maybe in factories, you know, high bay fixtures or